Hi and welcome to this, a proper introduction to my new siege map, Siege Orchard. A little backstory. So earlier in the year, around the end of June, I was finally able to figure out how the prefab for TF2 Siege Game Mode maps works. So I made the Snowtown map into a siege map as it was intended initially. So I got some new wind into my map making sails and decided to make a new siege map as an homage to the famous CP Orange map. I intended for the map to take place in an orange orchard. However, as you see the map right here, there are no oranges in sight. I did find some very nice orange color oak trees with help of people over at TF2 Maps Discord and decided to use those instead. As they were still orange, the thematic spirit was mostly kept, it was just changed. About making the map. I started making it right after I made the Siege Snowtown map in June. The first building to be made was the center tower. In the tower, I originally intended for the center stairway to be fully open so that you can like shoot from one stairway to another, but later I decided not to do that because I thought that it would be easily campable with sentries and sticky demos inside it. To be honest, sticky demos can camp pretty much anything, so I just left it like it is, with four stairways and full in the center, I guess. The payloads were always intended to be in the tunnel of the tower. To get to the payloads from the point, there are two options. You can either throw yourself out of one of the massive windows, or take the stairway back down. It was intended that the heavier classes with mobility and more health, like Demo and Soldier, would do this to break the possible campsite downstairs to allow squishier classes safe access to the payload through the stairs. The rim on the windows is that high on purpose. I did not want snipers sniping from the tower like in the original orange. There are many other avenues where they could snipe from, but for point control they could not. In fact, many of the windows were designed like this, with sniping and counter-sniping in mind. The rooms are mostly dimly lit, enabling fairly solid sniper play all around the map. Speaking of snipers, the big elephant mountains in the map. These mountains are here for sightline control, so that sniper in one of the stairwells of the tower cannot aid the push of the payload as much. This is also why the payload goes behind the mountain, not in front of it, on the quote-unquote faster route. Soldiers, scouts, demomen and flyers can all stand on top of this mountain, but not snipers. The trees, even though they were considered to be orange trees, had the same purpose. They were sightline control as well, in an effort to try and remedy the original orange map problem of it being very empty and allowing snipers and flying demomen to take reign over it. While the trees block vision, they do not block shots, so a sniper with good tracking can still take you down. Same with the bushes, they aren't solid and can be taken advantage of classes small enough to hide in them or sticky demos. Yes, these green grass blocks are bushes. Now shut up. Coming back to the buildings. Initially, the buildings were not supposed to be castles or castle architecture at all. As the map was initially going to be an orange orchard, the buildings were to be of farmy design instead. Kind of like on Harvest, with just the center tower only being the castle. This went out the window when I found no orange trees and decided that the other buildings should look like this too. So they are castles now. Since I made a payload go into the dual corner building, the map has two spawns. Big spawn behind the team castle and small two-floor spawn in the point where the enemy pushes the payload into. The castle where the teams fight out from the spawns were made elaborate for a purpose. This was originally going to be where you push the payload, but because the center tower has direct sightline of this building, I decided against it. And the payload went behind the mountain instead. I kept the castle as it is, however, because I had a use for something else in the future, which we will get to shortly. As this is only my third map, I still have some problems to sort out in map making, such as various habits, scaling, proper map, edge, termination, design, and others. Right now, and this is one of the big things I'm not happy about this map, is that the entire map just kind of sits inside a mountain ridge or something. It's not particularly interesting or creative. I need to figure out a better way to do that in later maps. Other problems related more to my map making in general became apparent when Tufti decided to test run this map on his server one stream. I had forgotten to pack the custom trees into the map, so it was basically an orchard of error signs. Not making that mistake again. A couple other takeaways from his playtime was that the map, as you see it right now, is a bit too big. The point fight in the tower is a bit too cramped as well, as the players would basically just spam or hide the openings of the stairwells at the top. So these problems will be addressed in the future. For now, the map as it is how I like it right now. I will, however, come back to it in the future. So the map also received a 5CP version, just like the source inspiration map of original Orange. This is where the team castles that I kept interesting come into play. They are the last points. The dual castle buildings are second points, and the tower is the middle point like before in the Siege version. The big difference, however, is that the spawns are now based on how many points you have kept, as per usual for 5CP map. So each team has three spawns. The first one that they start out with, the one in the second point as in the Siege version, and the third one is now inside the part of the tower that is solid, just under the point. And yeah, this is about it. Many thanks to anyone who helped me in the TF2 Maps Discord. Particular thanks go to UEAK Crash and his mapping tutorials, as well as Construction Zombie for making the Siege prefab on the TF2 map site. The maps are available for download in the description through TF2 Workshop. Thank you for watching and listening. Here are some questions you might have and answers to them. Question: why don't you update the map and make a video on that version? Answer to that is, I want to move on from this map for now, but I will return to it later. Question: why Siege? Because I play Paladins a lot these days and I like Siege game mode. I thought it would fit nicely in with TF2. Also, it's unlikely that Paladins is going to outlive Team Fortress 2, so this is kind of a fallback option I'm making for people that like Siege. Yeah, so when Paladins dies, you still have Siege maps in Team Fortress 2. Yeah, that's basically the idea. Question: why Orange? Answer: because Orange is the epitome of everyone's first or early Hammer maps. This is very much that, my third map. King of the Hill Snowtown being the first, and the second one I have never released. It is intended as an homage to Orange. Question: do you expect this crappy map to be accepted into the game? Answer to that is, no, I do not. In fact, the intent of this map is quite opposite. They are made for a community environment, not official environment. This allows for a bigger freedom of creation, while allowing some sloppiness as well. Also, the design errors aren't as critical here as it would be in an official environment. Question: after learning lessons from this map and not coming back to it for a while, what is next? Answer is, I'm slowly making a graveyard themed Siege map inspired from the graveyard design in Realm Royale. Question: hold on, Realm Royale? Isn't that the Battle Royale game? Answer to that is simple, yes it is. Question: why Realm as inspiration? It doesn't have Siege or anything related to Paladin's game modes entirely. The answer to that is, Realm is dying. I like Realm as well and want to preserve some of it in some fashion before its curtains for it. It is most likely that once Rogue Company, yet another high-risk game, takes off, the servers for Realm will be shut down. It already is a game receiving less maintenance than Team Fortress 2, and it launched in 2018. Question: so what are you gonna do with all the Siege map once you have a bunch of them? And the answer to that is, probably gonna host a server. Not sure exactly what I will do, but I'm kind of going towards that direction. And last question, why are you bothering with this anyway? It's not like you can have mounts in TF2 like you can in Paladins. And the answer to that is, the point isn't to duplicate Paladins exactly. It is simply the fact that it has had an impact on me, which I'm now passing on to the TF2 community for their quote-unquote enjoyment. And even if you don't enjoy, you would still see that an impact was had. Yeah, that's about it for this video.